Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you how you can perform sum of two dynamic 1D arrays in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search bar. My channel will be available there on first page. You can open it where you will be finding out various programming related videos and playlists. You can improve your programming skills by watching those videos. You can also download my programming app Techimiz, which is available on Google Play. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So first I am including a header file, that is stdio.h. Then another header file, stdlib. Now I am defining main function. Inside main function, I am declaring two pointers, p1 and p2, and size n1. And n2, then a variable I. Now I am going to display the message, enter size of first array. So through this I can read size of first array from user, and that will be stored inside n1. Now I can allocate dynamic memory to p1 pointer using malloc function. So here I am passing n into size of int. So this way dynamic memory will be allocated for p1 pointer, and size will be n1 into size of int. Now I can receive elements for first array, so the message will be enter elements of first array. Now through this loop I can read elements of first array from user. So here I am repeating scanf statement with this for loop, and inside scanf I am writing p1 plus i. So p1 is having base address of that memory location which is allocated through malloc. I is added every time in p1, so this way different locations will be available and the entered value will be stored at those locations. So this is the reading operation for first array. Now I am copying these statements and I am pasting them. So now I can change these statements for second array. So first enter size of second array message, then size will be received inside n2, then p2 pointer and n2 size, and then p2 plus i, and here enter elements of second array. So this way first and second arrays will be received from user. After receiving those elements, I can print sum on output screen. So again I am implementing for loop. Sorry, these loops will repeat n1 and n2 times. Now I am implementing another loop. So it can repeat n1 or it can repeat n2 times, because I am assuming that both sizes are same. So if you want to compare whether their sizes are different or same, you can apply if condition also like this. If n1 double equals to n2, so if they are equal, then only this addition operation will be performed, otherwise it will not be performed. So I can implement this. So if both the sizes are equal, then only this loop will be repeating. So here I am applying this statement, asterisk p1 plus i will be added with asterisk p2 plus i. So this way I have implemented the logic. Here this asterisk p1 plus i will be providing values of first array, and this asterisk p2 plus i will be providing elements of second array, and both will be added and the result will be printed on output screen. If these values are n1 and n2 are different, then I can print size of array is different. So addition will not be possible. At last, I can call free p1 and free p2 so that allocated memory can be freed and then return 0. So this way I have implemented the complete logic in front of you. Now I am going to execute this code. Sorry, here I have to write p2. Again, I am executing this code. I am entering size of array first is 5. Then I am entering 5 elements. Second array size is also 5. And I am entering 5 elements. You can see the sum 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. It is right because first array is containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And second array is also containing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So sum is perfect. Now again I am executing this code. This time I am entering 5 elements in first array and 4 elements in second array. So you can see the output. Sum size of array is different, so sum is not possible. So this way I have implemented the complete logic in front of you for addition of two dynamic arrays in C programming. I hope you have understood how I have implemented the logic. Sorry, how I have implemented the logic in front of you. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search Sanjay Gupta, that is my name, in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.